Welcome to SVR IAS Academy. In our today's video lecture, we are going to see about the Hindu newspaper analysis of 19th December 2017. This is page number 1 of Hindu newspaper, and this page contains two important articles from the perspective of UPSC Civil Services examination. The first article is regarding the stubble burning issue. We know that in the month of October and November, the entire northern India, especially the national capital region of India, that is New Delhi, is completely surrounded with the air pollution problem. Due to that air pollution, the people were severely affected, the railways were stopped and the air transport is stopped for a few days, and many of the students were also heavily affected due to this air pollution problem. Even some of the older people who were having the problem with lung issue is faced a critical time in those time period. And the main reason for this air pollution is rooted onto the stubble burning issue. Actually, the stubble burning is the practice which is followed in the states of Haryana, Punjab, and also in some other northern states. The stubble burning is a practice in which the farmer used to burn the stubble which is left out in his field after harvesting. The reason for such kind of a burning is it is cost effective mode from the perspective of farmers. As a result, the farmer simply go and burn all the stubble which is left over in his field after the harvesting. But these kind of a primitive mode of agriculture followed by the farmers of northern India will lead on to lot of negative consequences. One such consequence is the air pollution problem, and apart from that, even the soil fertility in this farmland will also get reduced. So as a result, the Union Government has framed a clear policy in this regard to address this issue. Now, the Union Government has completely banned the practice of stubble burning in these states, and the data regarding the current practice of stubble burning is closely monitored using the satellite data. And apart from that, the awareness program is created among these farmers regarding the drawbacks of practicing the stubble burning. And a separate task force is created for promoting the alternative practices like the Happy Feeder initiatives. And that is what all about this stubble burning article. Now let us move on to next article. The second article is one of the important articles from the perspective of UPSC Civil Services preliminary examination, because it contains the factual information regarding some of the development which has taken place in the Kerala. Once upon a time, this manuscript magazine with elegant calligraphy is one of the popular mode of communication which channels the creativity of the writer. But with time and with the advancement of printing technology, this manuscript magazine with elegant calligraphy slowly faded away in the attraction of the common people. In order to revive this older tradition, that is, in order to revive this manuscript magazine with elegant calligraphy, recently the Department of Economics and Statistics in Kerala have come up with a novel idea. And the idea is, this department has launched a new manuscript magazine called as Kaiyeluthu Maliga. The main aim of this Kaiyeluthu Maliga manuscript magazine is to promote the Malayalam literature and also to give a creative break to its staff. That is, in general, the staff who were employed in the Department of Economic and Statistics were already overburdened with the work of statistics, surveys and computations. In order to give them a recreational break, this department has decided to promote the manuscript magazine among its workers. On taking cue regarding these developments, the Economic and Statistics department located in the Ernakulam district is the first one to launch a manuscript magazine in the name of Niraweb. And this development is followed by the Economics and Statistics department in the Kottayam and Wayanad, and they have initiated the manuscript magazine in the name of Kayyoppu, that is signature, and Kadir in their respective districts. And the main advantage of promoting the manuscript magazine is it will benefit the art and literature of the respective language. And also, the versatility of calligraphy helps in retaining the vibrancy of the language. That is what all about this article. Now let us move on to next article. This is page number 2 of Hindu newspaper, and this page contains two important articles from the perspective of UPSC Civil Services examination. The first article is regarding the Punjab state government's observation regarding the kite flying. Actually, the kite flying is one of the recreational sport which is played all over the world. Even some nations were also having a separate day which is allocated for celebrating the festival of kite flying. This kite flying is also offering a huge amount of recreational value to the people who are practicing it. At the same time, it is also having some of the dangers. That is, by the usage of the kite strings which were made up of nylon, plastic and the synthetic materials like Chinese manja were causing the huge amount of danger to the human life as well as to the lives of cattle, birds, as well as it is also hurting the soil and the ecology of the region. As a result, the Punjab state government has decided to completely ban the manufacture, sale and production of this kite strings which were made of these kind of materials. The Punjab state government also said that it will permit only the kite strings which were made up of cotton threads which does not contain any sort of sharp metallic glass components or adhesives and other thread strengthening materials. This is the observation which is made by the Punjab state government regarding the kite flying. That is what all about this article. Now let us move on to next article. This is the second article from this page, and this article is discussing about the recent verdict of Karnataka High Court regarding the pictorial warnings on tobacco products. Earlier, in the 2014, the Union Government has come up with some rules and regulations regarding the pictorial warning on tobacco products. That is, the Union Government has come up with the cigarette and other tobacco products packaging and labeling amendment rules of 2014. According to this rule, 85% of the pictorial warning should be present on the packages of cigarette and other tobacco products. These rules formally came into effect in the month of April 2016. Even though these rules were received a lot of support from the common citizens as well as from the social activists, but still these rules also faced with a wide criticisms. The major opposition came from the Tobacco Institute of India and also the manufacturers of cigarette, bidi and other tobacco products. The cases against this cigarette and other tobacco product amendment rules of 2014 is registered in the High Courts of Karnataka, Calcutta, Delhi, Bombay, Gujarat and also in Rajasthan. Since the number of cases which were registered against this particular rules is keep on increasing, the Supreme Court has transferred all such cases to the High Court of Karnataka. In this scenario, recently the Karnataka High Court come up with the verdict of the pictorial warning on tobacco products. This Karnataka High Court has stated that the cigarette and other tobacco product packaging and labeling amendment rules of 2014 is unconstitutional. As a result, it has nullified the 2014 rules and it has reverted back to the 2008 rules regarding the pictorial warning on tobacco products. As a result, it is virtually a legal battle won by the cigarette companies on the Union government. Here, now coming back to the 2008 rules, the 2008 rules mandated the cigarette manufacturers to maintain 40% of the principal area of the package with the pictorial warning on the usage of tobacco products. Even though it is a victory of a legal battle, but still the health activists all over the India were opposing this move of Karnataka High Court. The main reason is the reducing of size of the pictorial warning will work much in the favor of players of tobacco industry, especially the tobacco manufacturers, and not in the interest of the people. That is the first point which is stated by the health activist while opposing this verdict. And the second important reason is the bigger pictorial warnings is very much important for reducing the youth who were getting addicted to the tobacco products. These are the two important reasons which were put forth by the health activists who were working against the usage of tobacco. In this scenario, it is also very much important to know about GATS. Actually, GATS is the abbreviation of Global Adult Tobacco Survey. According to this Global Adult Tobacco Survey, the usage of tobacco is gradually declining in India, and it has stated that the reduction in the usage of tobacco is primarily due to the VAT tax which is levied on the tobacco products, that is value added tax which is levied against the tobacco product is considerably reduced the usage of tobacco among the population. And also, due to the pictorial warning, certain percentage of the people were decided to quit the usage of tobacco products. So that is what all given in this article. Now let us move on to next article. This is page number 5 of Hindu newspaper, and this page contains one important article from the perspective of General Studies paper 3 of UPSC Civil Services Examination. This article is regarding the recent forest fire which takes place in the Somanakad Valley of Barimale region in the Charmandi range of Western Ghats. Here you have to note down, the forest fire is a common phenomena in forest in general, especially in the summer season. But unfortunately, the forest fire which takes place in the Charmandi range of Western Ghats is occurring in the winter season. So it is an anomaly. And on taking the closer look on this anomaly, the environmentalists were stating that these forest fires were caused not because of a natural cause, instead, these forest fires were caused because of the human activity. The environmentalists were speculating that these forest fires were created by the humans with an aim to encroach on the reserve forest area land. On cognizing this issue, the Union government is planning to take action against those who were setting the forest on fire for the encroachment purpose. That is, those who were found guilty have to be punished. That is the motto of Union Government of India in this regard. In this background, it is important for you to know regarding the Western Ghat region. Actually, the Western Ghat region is the home for the Shola forest and also for a wide variety of grasslands. And the Western Ghats is also one of the hotspots which is present in India, which has a wide variety of endemic species of flora and fauna. And one more important point you have to note regarding this Charmandi range of Western Ghats is, this Charmandi range of Western Ghats is the source for the Netravati river tributaries. Since Netravati river is already drying up in some parts of the region, by having the frequent forest fire in this place will lead on to the reduction in the water flow of Netravati river. As a result, it will accelerate the river drying up. So it is also one of the huge problem which is associated with the frequent forest fire which is occurring in the Charmandi range of Western Ghats. And from the preliminary examination point of view, it is important for you to note it down that the Charmandi range is located in the Western Ghats in the state of Karnataka. That is what all about this article. And now let us move on to next article. In the very same page, there is also one more article is present. The article is regarding the forest range which is located in Andhra Pradesh. Here, the content of the article is not very much important from the perspective of the examination, but The factual information which is provided is very much important from the map reading questions of UPSC preliminary examination. There are three important locations is given regarding the forest range and the parks in Andhra Pradesh. The first is the Nagarjuna Sagar forest range, which is located in Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh. The second is Srisailam forest range, is also located in the Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh. And then Sri Venkateshwara Zoological Park is located in Tirupati. These are the three important locations. You have to mark it on your map so that you can refer it in future for your examination, especially for your preliminary examination. Now let us move on to next article. This is page number 7 of Hindu newspaper, and this page contains 4 important articles from the perspective of UPSC Civil Services examination. The first article is regarding the Bhagat Singh, and the second article is regarding the Rafael deal, and the third article is regarding the Enemy Properties Act, and the fourth article is regarding the introduction of tiger in the state of Odisha. The first article is regarding the Bhagat Singh. Actually, this article is very much important from the perspective of the history syllabus of the examination. We know that the Bhagat Singh and Rajguru were participated in the revolutionary terrorist activity in the year of 1928. During their activism, they have fatally shot a British junior police officer whose name is John Sanders in Lahore, after mistakenly considering him as a British police superintendent. As a result, the Lord Irwin, who is the Viceroy of India by that time, has constituted a separate tribunal to investigate the cases against Bhagat Singh and Rajguru, and the special tribunal has sentenced the Bhagat Singh and Rajguru along with Shukdev to a death by hanging at Lahore jail. The hanging of these three freedom fighters have taken place in the year of 1931, and that is the important concept which is provided in this article. Now let us move on to next article. The second article is regarding the Rafael aircraft. Actually, in the year of 2000, the Indian Air Force along with Ministry of Defense have submitted a proposal for the procurement of 126 Mirage 2000 jets. This Mirage 2000 jets were meant to replace the MiG-21s which were in service. This MiG-21s is converted into a medium multi-role combat aircraft recently, and the request for proposal for such is issued in the year of 2000. Of the proposed 126 Mirage 2000 jets, 18 were supposed to be in direct flyaway condition and 108 were supposed to be manufactured in India. In this scenario, the field evaluation trials were conducted for the 6 vendors who were participated in this bidding. Among the 6 vendors, only 2 vendors have successfully remained as a compliant of the norms of Indian Air Force. Among these 2 vendors, the Dassault Aviation has successfully won the bid. But unfortunately, due to the hurdles, this request for proposal which is earlier submitted for 126 Mirage 2000 jets were formally withdrawn. In this scenario, in order to meet the critical requirement of Indian Air Force for the jets, the Indian government has signed an agreement with the French government in the name of Intergovernmental Agreement for procurement of 36 Rafale jets. These 36 Rafale aircraft will be available to the Indian Air Force in a flyaway condition. Even though this agreement is signed between the Indian and the French government years ago, only now the Cabinet Committee on Security has formally cleared this bill. That is what all about this article. Now let us move on to next article. The third important article in this page is regarding the Enemy Properties Act. First, let us know what is meant by enemy properties. The enemy properties are the properties which were belonging to the people who had left for countries like Pakistan or China during the war which takes place between these nations is what termed as the enemy properties. In the year of 2017, the Union Government has come up with the Enemy Property Act to include the disposal or transfer of enemy properties. Now, the Union Home Ministry has submitted its approval for disposing of this enemy properties. That is what given in this article. And now let us move on to next article. The fourth article is regarding the tiger conservation. Recently, the Odisha state government has shows its willingness to the Madhya Pradesh government for translocating the tigers of Madhya Pradesh to the Satakosha Tiger Reserve in Odisha. The Satakoshia Tiger Reserve in Odisha is having a good amount of healthy prey base. The Satakoshia Tiger Reserve is having a huge population of barking deer as well as wild boars. These two prey variety is very much good to sustain the tiger population in Satakoshia Tiger Reserve. From the perspective of UPSC Civil Services examination, it is very much important to mark it on your map the locations of various tiger reserves which were located in Madhya Pradesh as well as in the state of Odisha. That is what all about this article, and now let us move on to next article. This is page number 13 of Hindu newspaper, and this page contains three important articles regarding the recent announcement of IRDAI. Recently, the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India has announced that the health expenditure which were made by Indians were mostly the out-of-pocket expenditure. That is, roughly around 62% of the healthcare cost were out-of-pocket expenditure. 62% of out-of-pocket expenditure is a huge amount, and such kind of an expenditure will lead on to the impoverishment of the patients. So, the government have to take adequate measures to reduce the out-of-pocket expenditure of patients. When compared to the developed nations, the India is performing very poor in this regard. The United States of America and the United Kingdom were recording only 20% of out-of-pocket healthcare expenditure. And when we compare the BRICS countries, the BRICS countries were only accounting for 20-25% of out-of-pocket expenditure. But in contrast, India is showing 62% of out-of-pocket healthcare expenditure. So as a result, the policy change is must in this regard. India have to create a health insurance product which were both simple as well as intelligible to the customers. That is, it have to provide coverage to the aged and also to the infirm patients who were suffering from chronic ailments, and also it have to bring down the distribution cost and ensure that there shouldn't be any kind of profiteering is taking place to the detriment of insured patient. This is the most important criteria from the perspective of the new policy which have to be framed in this regard. The Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India chairman also proposed a community group insurance product. According to this community group insurance product, the veracity of the insurance claims will be verified by the members of the community itself. Thereby, the fake claim can be rectified. That is the demand which is put forth for the creation of community group insurance products. These are the important articles which were provided in here. And one more important announcement which is made by Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, that is IRDAI, is it want to affix or merge the Aadhaar card details with the insurance policy within March 31 of 2018. That is one of the other important information which is given in this article. Now let us move on to next article. The next important article is regarding the recent announcement of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. Recently, the TRAI, that is Telecom Regulatory and Authority of India, has announced that the per port transaction charge will be reduced to rupees 4 from the present value of rupees 19. You may have the doubt, what is meant by per port transaction? Actually, the per port transaction is the amount which is paid by the telecom operator to whom The subscriber opts to port his number to the mobile number portability service provider. That is, if you are using the service of X SIM card and you are planning to transfer to the Z SIM card, then in such cases, the X SIM card service provider have to pay rupees 4 to the Z SIM card service provider. This is what known as per port transaction charge. Initially, this option for porting is provided to the users in the day of July 3rd of 2015. This is the day when the Pan India MNP was permitted. And here you have to note down, after July 3rd of 2015, the quantum of the request for porting or portability is keep on increasing. So on considering this, the rupees 19 which is paid to the service provider at present is very much huge amount. So on considering this fact, now the Union Government, especially the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, has decided to cut down this 19 rupees value to the rupees 4. And also you have to note down, this 4 rupees is the transaction which is made between the telecom operators. It doesn't concerns regarding the amount paid by the subscriber to the porting option. At present, the amount paid by the subscriber for porting his number from one service provider to another service provider is also rupees 19. And also, the TROI has recently observed that the amount to be paid by the subscriber cannot be more than per port transaction charge. As a result, there is a likely possibility that the amount paid by the subscriber will also be reduced to rupees 4 in coming days. That is what all about the recent announcement of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. And now let us move on to next article. This is page number 9 of Hindu newspaper, and this page contains 4 important article or 4 important editorials from the perspective of UPSC Civil Services Examination. The first article is regarding the urban heat island effect, and the second article is regarding the income inequality issue. The third article is regarding the cyber safety, and the fourth article is regarding the Indian contribution on the science. This is the first important article, and this article is regarding the urban heat island effect. First, let us see what is meant by urban heat island effect. The urban heat island effect is a phenomenon in which the urban region is warmer when you compare with the surrounding non-urban or rural areas. Such kind of a phenomenon is what known as urban heat island effect. This sort of urban heat island effect occurs due to the rapid and unplanned urbanization process, as well as it occurs due to the drastic reduction of vegetation in this region. These two processes or these two activity results negatively in the thermal and radioactive properties of the region or surface. As a result, the heat gets trapped up. As a result, it results in the urban heat island effect. If you want to counter this urban heat island effect, you have to minimize the heat trapping area. For this to happen, you have to properly plan the urbanization, as well as you have to properly plan the cities before constructing different buildings. And also, you have to properly maintain the vegetation cover in the cities to reduce the impact of the urban heat island effect. On considering the recent proposals regarding the smart city and the recent stress on the urbanization, the Union Government have to properly concentrate on these sort of phenomena, and also they have to make sure the urban dwellers not to suffer due to the excessive heat and rainfall pattern in general. That is what all about today's newspaper analysis. For further topics regarding the UPSC examination and further notes regarding various important topics of UPSC examination, do visit our official homepage www.comeonindia.com. You can also download our Android app from the Google Play Store. Just search SVR IAS Academy in the Google Play Store to get our Android app. All the best for your examinations. Thank you.